Living cells are the ultimate engineering substrate. They are the most difficult thing out there to be able to control. Imagine being able to engineer a living cell that can navigate the human body, identify disease, and correct that disease. That requires that the cells be able to sense where they are in the body, detect a disease state, and deliver a therapeutic. And that's something that biology, we know it can do, but we don't know how to harness that as part of a medicine. I'm a synthetic biologist, and I'm in the biological engineering department at MIT. Well, I've actually never taken biology. So as an undergrad, I was a chemical engineer, and I very slowly got involved in biophysics, first with proteins, and then I became interested in how proteins come together in pathways and how the pathways come together to form a cell. So I sort of increased the scale at which I thought about living systems. And as I did that, I started to learn those types of techniques and theory to go along with that. Right now, I essentially run two groups. I run a group at MIT, and that involves graduate students and postdocs. And the thing that's really characteristic is how broad their backgrounds are. So we have biologists and chemical engineers and electrical engineers and computer science, people from just about every field that you can imagine coming together. I also recently started something called the MIT Broad Foundry for Synthetic Biology. And this is where we're working with the Broad Institute in order to develop a manufacturing pipeline that enables the physical construction of DNA that is much larger and more sophisticated, meaning you have more parts than was previously possible. I think this is the century of genetic engineering. There are sensors that sit in the cell membrane, and they're receiving environmental information. There are circuits that process that information, and there are things that actuate where the cell can do. And so, in large part, we view living cells as robotic-like systems that can be reprogrammed to do things that they don't normally do. Something that's really important for engineering biology is being able to tell genes under what conditions and what timing they should turn on. So to do this, we created a programming language for bacteria. So you would go in as a user, and using a language very much like what you would use to program a computer, you write what you want the cell to do, and then the software figures out what the DNA sequence is that encodes the protein, so that when you put it into the cells, they run the program and are able to perform that computation. There are applications in this research from new materials to pharmaceuticals to chemicals, agriculture. Essentially, anything that you see biology and nature doing, we would like to be able to go in and manipulate that so that we can create new materials and pharmaceuticals and so on. Traditionally, biology has been separated by what type of organism you work in. But now people are looking at cross systems, and they'll say, well, I need this enzyme from a human cell or this structural protein from a yeast. And they mix and match and combine them in order to create the living system that does what it wants it to do. And as you go further and further, you can imagine more and more sophisticated things. As we learn how to engineer the biology and how to build the genetics, we're going to continually be able to access more sophisticated products from the field.